Today, we are diving into how you can edit single clips in your iPhone's native Photos app. You're already familiar with the Photos app, as it is the place where we view and organize our photos and videos. But not everyone realizes that it's also a tool for editing video clips. Much like editing a photo, you can enhance your videos, adjust colors, trim unwanted parts, and more. When shooting video, we often capture much more footage than we need, and it's our job to go through these clips, identifying the best moments and cutting out the less necessary parts. The result? A concise video that showcases only the best parts of your recorded moments. So now, let's open our Photos app, and then I'm gonna go into the favorite folder, and I'm gonna pick a random clip. Let's say this one. Now from here, we'll be able to see obviously our clip, but then we can tap on edit, and here we can enter the edit mode in our Photos app. On the top left corner, you can see that there is a volume button. From here, you'll be able to mute your clip. Then if you retap it again, you'll be able to reactivate the volume. Then you see that there is a preview of your video. This is called timeline. And from here, you can drag this vertical white line, which is called playhead, around the video. So that in case you want to see the video towards the end, you can just drag the playhead without having to wait the whole time. And there you go. If you hold the playhead for a second, you'll be able to enter the precise mode, which means that you don't see the preview of the whole video, but just you see a couple of seconds so that you can move frame by frame within the video. Then if you click on play, you'll be able to start reviewing the video from where the playhead is. So I can drag the playhead at any time, then go at the beginning and again click on play, and this will start showcasing the video. From the timeline, we'll also be able to trim the video. We can drag the left handle towards the right if we want to trim it from the beginning, but then we can also drag the right handle towards the left to trim the end. That's it. Now we've selected a portion of our clip, but I want to make it more precise, so let's have it until we see the London Eye, probably like here, and then until I start moving from the beginning. I think right here should be fine. Then you can tap on done, and here you have two options, either save video or save video as a new clip. If you save video as a new clip, this will export only the part that you selected in a completely new video. But if you save video, this will modify that clip that you used, but don't worry because you'll be able to revert all the adjustments that you made until you go back to the original. But let me show you what I mean by that. If we tap on save video, now we can see that the preview in the Photos app is showing me only the part that we selected. But then when I tap on edit again, we can see that the full original video is still there. I can still drag the handle towards the left or right and modify my original clip. Now, in the bottom part of the screen, you can see that we have a few buttons. The first one being video, so this is where we see the timeline. Then we have adjust. Here you'll be able to adjust lighting and colors of the clip. The first one is auto. In this case, iPhone will do everything for you. For now, let's reset it to zero, so let's tap on it again. In each of these points, you have a slider. So you'll be able to drag left or right on the slider to add or remove that effect. So for example, now I'm in exposure. If I drag my finger towards the left, I'll be able to increase the exposure up to 100. Now, obviously this is too bright. So what I can do is that I can drag the slider again towards the zero. And if I drag it towards the right, then this will make the clip darker. This is valid for every single property that we mentioned. So it's totally up to you in case you want to modify the lighting and the colors of your videos. For now, let's reset it to zero. And then we're just going to tap on auto so that iPhone will do the job for us. Then the next button is filters. Here we have some built-in presets. So by dragging our fingers towards the right, we'll be able to change the look of it. And let's go into dramatic because this is my favorite. In the bottom part, you have a slider. Here you can choose the intensity of the effect. So if you drag towards the right, you'll be able to go up to zero, where you basically see just the original clip. But if you drag it towards the left, you can see it up to 100, where you have the effect at maximum intensity. So let's go back to 50. And then let's have a look at the other presets that we have. Dramatic warm, really nice. Dramatic cool, also really nice. And then we have a bunch for black and white. The next is the crop button. And from here, we'll be able to crop the clip. If you drag on the top right corner, for example, you'll be able to modify and select just the part of the clip that you want to show. Then with this button right here, we'll be able to change the aspect ratio. And here we can change it to 9x16, 4x5, 5x7, and so on and so forth. Also, you'll be able to change it from the vertical to horizontal format. But now let's go back and reset to the original file. Then we have the possibility to rotate by clicking on this button. And then we can go to 180 degrees, 270, or back to original. Then we can also flip it by clicking on this button. So let's say you want to post it on Instagram in the normal feed. Well, the format is 4x5. So you're going to click on 4x5 and then you want to have it vertical. That's it. Now there is one last button that we haven't covered yet, which is the three dots in the top right corner. This will allow you to copy edits, which means that we can paste them in other clips. So let's do that. Let's copy these edits. Then we're going to click on done on this video. Then you can go to another clip. Let's say this one. And then you tap on the three dots and you tap on paste edits. This feature pastes only lighting and color adjustments. You can do this operation in several clips so that you maintain consistency with lighting and colors. To do so, you just need to select the other clips that you want to modify, and then you're gonna click on the three dots and tap on paste edits. And that's it. Remember that the most important aspect is to carefully select the best clips and to identify the best parts of each clip to tell a compelling story. Not every second of footage will make the final cut, and that's okay. It's about quality, not quantity. It's about finding those perfect moments. Keep in mind that your creative journey doesn't stop when you finish recording. In fact, it continues with how you edit your footage. The editing process is another opportunity to bring your vision to life, to add your unique touch, and to truly make your video your own. So take these editing tools we've looked at today and see what you can come up with. You'd be surprised what you can do with the Photos app on your iPhone. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm going to see you in the next one.
This preview of the iPhone Video Academy offers a sneak peek into the incredible world of iPhone videography. Get ready to unlock the secrets, techniques, and skills that will transform your videos into works of art. But wait, there's more. In the full course, you embark on an immersive learning journey covering every aspect of iPhone videography. From mastering camera techniques to refining your editing skills, the iPhone Video Academy has it all. Don't miss this chance to become a true iPhone videography expert. You'll find the link in the description right under this video. Click on that link to find out more about iPhone Video Academy, and I'll see you inside the full course.